Hi everyone and welcome back to Creative PowerPoint. Today, we'll learn how to make a PowerPoint presentation with a neumorphic design. Neumorphic design was invented in 2020. It's gaining an increasing popularity among the designer community. Once you understand the principles, you'll be able to create presentations with stunning visuals. We'll illustrate with an interactive presentation that shows multiple variations of a sports car. We can select the color of a car and the type of exterior. If you want to follow along, you'll find the link to the example and a reference sheet in the comments of this video. Let's go! Before I explain how to create a neumorphic design in PowerPoint, I need to explain what a neumorphic design is. Today, there are two major approaches in interaction design. One of them is called skeuomorphism. The idea is to make objects on a screen look like their physical counterparts. You can see here a button that looks like a physical button. In 2013, a new design language emerged called flat design. At that time, the designer said that everybody knows what a button is, so we don't need buttons on a screen to look like physical buttons anymore. So they got rid of the bevels and came with that minimalistic design language. Both approaches have their pros and cons. We've seen some initiatives try to find a middle ground between skeuomorphism and flat design. Material design was one of them, and neumorphism is the latest one. It emerged in 2020, and it's the contraction of new skeuomorphism. The overall idea of neumorphism is to use cards or buttons that look like they were extruded or carved from the background. It plays with light and shadows to achieve this effect. Let's see how we make a neumorphic slide. To build a neumorphic slide, we need the slide background to be a light gray. I propose to use this color, EFEE. Feel free to adapt to your liking. Let's go through the steps together. Right-click on the slide background, select Format Background, select Solid Fill for the background. Under the color drop-down, click on More Colors. Enter the hex color EFEEE. Now, let's build our first extruded card. You can notice the light reflection at the top left and the dark shadow at the bottom right. PowerPoint cannot yet add two shadows to a shape, so as I walk around, we are going to superimpose two identical shapes, one with a light reflection as a white shadow and the other one with a dark shadow. For both shapes, the background color is the same as the slide background. I've shown here the color parameters of both shapes, but you can find the reference guide in the downloads of this video. Let's go through the steps together. We are going to create a rounded rectangle, but you can create a circle with the same procedure. Go to the Insert tab and insert your shape. Duplicate the rectangle with Command D on a Mac or Control D on Windows. For the first shape, add an outer top left shadow. Select color white, change transparency to 0%, size is 100%, blur is 8 points, distance 6 points. Click on the second shape and add an outer bottom right shadow. Make sure the color is black. Change transparency to 50%. Size is 100%, blur is 8 points, and distance 6 points. Select the two shapes and change a background color to be the same as the slide background, in our case EFEE. Deactivate the lines for the shapes. Now we need to superimpose the shapes. The safest way is to go to the Home tab, Align Group, and select Align Left. Then again, go to the Home tab, Align Group, and Align Top. We have built our first extruded card. Let's see two techniques to carve a card from the background. For carved shapes, we cannot use the same trick with the two identical shapes, because one shape will hide the shadow of the other one. there are two workarounds. The first workaround uses a single shape. It uses an inner shadow at the top left and a light gradient at the bottom right. This generates this diffuse light at the bottom right. Let's go through the steps together. Go to the Insert tab and insert your shape. Go to the Shape Effects, add an inner top left shadow, make sure color is black. Transparency is 50%, blur 8 points, and distance 6 points. Go to the shape background, set a gradient fill, remove the middle gradient stops by dragging them away. Add a gradient stop at around 75%. The first gradient stop will have the same color as the slide background. We use the exact same color for the second gradient stop. For the last gradient stop, it will be white. Set an angle of 70% for the gradient, disable the line for the shape, and you're done. There's a second method which can sometimes give better results for the light. I use a combination of two shapes. The first one is the big one at the middle of your screen. The second one is a very thin shape at the bottom right of the main shape. I added an outline so that we can see it. It's here to create the light strip. Let's separate the two shapes. Again, I've shown here the color parameters of both shapes, but you can find the reference guide in the downloads of this video. Let's go through the steps together. Go to the Insert tab and insert your shape. Duplicate the shape twice with Command-D on macOS or Control-D on Windows. Make sure the three shapes are aligned. Select the three of them. In the Home tab, in the Arrange group, select Align Top. Then redo the alignment, but this time select Align Left. Unselect all shapes and select the top shape. Nudge it 10 pixels to the bottom and 10 pixels to the right using the arrow keys on your keyboard. With the Shift key held, click on the second shape to select it. Go to the Shape Format tab, under the Merge Shape group, select Subtract. This creates this thin shape at the bottom right. On this thin shape, add an outer top left shadow. Make sure color is white. Set transparency to 0%. Size is 100%. Blur is 8 points. Distance 6 points. On the main shape, add an inner top left shadow. Make sure color is black. Set transparency to 50%, blur 8 points, and distance 6 points. Select both shapes. Set a solid fill for both shapes with the same color as the slide background. Disable the line for both shapes, and you are done. Now that we know how to create the basic shapes, the rest is pretty easy. I covered many of these concepts in my previous videos, so I'll go quite fast. You can download the example file to inspect it. I have one slide for every possible car color combination. For every slide, I've copy-pasted the right shape to build my buttons, either the extruded form or the curved one. For the transition between slides, I use the morph transition. I've used the advanced naming scheme for the morph transition. If a shape name starts with two exclamation marks, PowerPoint tries to morph the shape into the shape of the other slide with the same name. On every button, I've added a hyperlink that brings to the correct slide. And for the cores, I've inserted them from Microsoft stock 3D models. Let's see the result one last time. Et voilà. Thanks for watching. Make sure you don't miss my upcoming videos. Subscribe to my channel, like and share with your friends. And don't forget, every creative day has a creative PowerPoint. See you next week. Bye bye.